Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I'm using the TI-36X PRO today to solve problems where you're trying to find a z-score given an area. So in this particular problem, it's a little more complicated because we're given that the z-score, yikes, the picture not great, but anyways, we're going from negative c to positive C, and the area between those two areas is 0.2892. I should say the area between those two z-scores, not areas. So that's what I want to figure out, is what is C. But remember, my calculator is finding things to the left. So what I really want to do is find out what this area over here is, and then I can put that in to find this value. And then I can make it positive to find the C value. So what I'm going to do is take the area that I was given, and I'm going to subtract that from 1. So I'm going to take 100% of my area, and I'm going to subtract the part that I'm actually interested in. So that is 1 minus 0.2892. And that equals 0.7108. And that means that these two areas over here together are 0.7108. And I'm really just interested in this one. So hopefully you can see that I need to divide this by 2 to figure out the area over there. So I'm going to divide that value by 2. And that means that I get 0.3554 for my area over here. All right, and that's what I'm going to put in my calculator. So I had to do a few things to make that happen, right? I had to take away the area that I was given to find the outer edges and then divide that by 2 because I was looking at both tails and I really just wanted to look at the left one. So 0.3554. So my function here is second function data. Go over to distribution and go down to inverse normal. The area that I'm interested in is 0.3554. You don't need to put the zero in there, but anyway, the mean and the sigma are automatically 0 and 1, and that's what I want for this problem, so now I can hit calculate. And that gives me that negative C is negative 0.37. And you should look at these values to two places, and that means that the positive C value here would be 0.37. So I have my range here goes from negative 0.37 up to positive 0.37. So that's less than one standard deviation, which we would expect because one standard deviation on either side is much greater values. Okay, have a fantastic day, and we'll see you next time.